Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. This is the first time I have actually sat in front of my camera since I believe the spring to film a video, and not gonna lie, it feels a little bit awkward talking to the camera again, but at the same time it also feels really good. I don't know why I always forget this, but makeup just takes me to my happy place, and I'm so glad that I'm diving back into it, getting creative, and slowly, and I mean very slowly, starting to film again. Today's video was completely unplanned, and the only reason I think I'm really filming right now is because my order just arrived, the idea came to me, and I thought, why not? So here we are. And as you can imagine from the title of the video, we are going to be comparing two different Anastasia palettes. Technically, they're not different. They're the exact same palette, but one is 5 years old and the other one is brand spanking new. If that's something that sounds interesting to you, then make sure you keep on watching, and also don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss those future uploads when they eventually start happening. Like I said, we are going to be comparing this Anastasia palette right here. It is the Modern Renaissance, which quickly became a cult favorite, and truth be told, it was one of my favorite palettes when it first dropped as well. I don't often use a lot of eyeshadow in my day-to-day, like if I'm just going to work, hanging out at home, whatever, but this is a palette that received quite a bit of love from me. I don't know if you can see this, but it is a little bit messy. I mean, mind you, I just use it right now for my makeup, but generally speaking, I've dipped into these colors quite a bit, and because this was one of my beloved palettes, I thought I would update it. And the reason is this one is 5 years old. I bought it when it first came out many, many moons ago, and I feel like the formula is, you know, getting to that expiration date, if not already expired, but I just keep dipping into it anyways. This Modern Renaissance palette, which is the brand new one, happened to be on sale at Sephora Canada for 50% off. I paid $30 plus tax for it, and I thought, you know what, this is a great time to update and throw away the old one, bring in the new one. But I didn't want to do that until I tested out both palettes to make sure the formula was still the same. As you are probably aware, ABH has gone through quite the journey over the last decade. They have released so many cult favorite products, especially brow products. They had a lot of really great eye palettes, and then somewhere between releasing an eyeshadow palette every couple of months, Norvina decided to launch her own sub-brand underneath the ABH umbrella, which became so confusing, and personally, I just did not like those palettes or those formulas at all. I know some people are obsessed with them. I'm not one of those people. What I did like is that the brand took a step back and reevaluated what they were doing. I would hope they listened to all of the feedback that they were receiving from their clients, and so they haven't been releasing very much, if anything. I believe a mascara came out as well as an eyeliner, and I think that's it. To be honest, I just haven't heard that much from ABH, and I'm not mad at that. And because there's been so much up and down with the brand, I thought, let me see if the formula between these two Modern Renaissance palettes is still the same. And in order to do that, I went ahead and created the look that you see right here. It is very simple, nothing complex. I just did a smoky eye using some of the most neutral tones I could find in this palette. So a little bit of brown, a little bit of orange, and one of my absolute favorite shades that I think ABH has ever released. It's called Tempera. It is this bone color that's got a little bit of shimmer to it, but it is very, very satin in its finish. I think it finishes off a lot of looks beautifully. Overall, I think the old palette and the new palette performed pretty much the same, although I do have some thoughts on a couple of the colors that I used. I'm gonna bring in my tiny little mirror here for inspection. And I'm gonna start with the first shade that I put on, which is Tempera. I put that on my brow bone over my primer. I did use this primer right here. It's the P. Louise Base Rumor number two. It's one of my favorite primers. Color matches perfect for me, and it really helps glue shadow down to my lid, and I don't get that much creasing whenever I use it. So I wanted to give this eyeshadow the best chance possible to succeed. And so Tempera went on beautifully, both with the old palette as well as the new palette. I had zero complaints. Although if I'm being honest, I did sit and stare into the mirror for a little bit as the light reflected off of Tempera because it looked so pretty. After Tempera, I went in with Red Ochre. I wanted something that was gonna be a little bit deeper in my crease, and I didn't necessarily wanna go Venetian Red, which is this shade over here. That is definitely leaning more towards red, as the name would suggest, but it's got those burgundy vibes and I didn't wanna go towards the mauve route. I definitely wanted to stick more towards those orange tones. And so Red Ochre seemed to fit the bill. It blended the way I remember it blending back in the day, and I just loved the shade. It did not change at all in the new palette as well. It was just as good, just as pigmented, and it blended out just as easily. I did notice though in both palettes that there was a lot of kick up in the actual pans themselves. So when you dip your eyeshadow brush in there, you have to tap so gently, because I'm telling you, if you're gonna stab your brush in there, you are absolutely gonna get a lot of kick up. After Red Ochre, I went in with Realgar. I think that's how you say it. It's this really nice deeper orange shade at the end of the second row. That went on so nicely, and it added that deeper orange that I was really looking for. I actually forgot to add that onto the other eye when I was using the new palette. I ended up doing it towards the end after I added all of my shadows on into my crease. The shade still performed beautifully. I thought it was exactly the same in both palettes. After Realgar, I went in with Burnt Orange, which is this shade over here. This is one of the most neutral brownie orange tone shades you're ever going to find. It is delightful, and I find it really finishes off your crease beautifully, and that's what I wanted to do. I was creating this gradient, and Burnt Orange just finished it off perfectly. I love that shade. Burnt Orange in the new palette looked just as nice. It blended out beautifully, was pigmented the way this eye was. I loved it. Now here is this shade that I thought was just a smidge different in both palettes, or maybe it was just the way that I was applying it, but Cypress Umber, which is one of my favorite deeper browns in this palette. I don't want to say it was problematic because it really wasn't, but it just applied differently to both eyes. So I found the old one went on exactly like I remembered. It was deep brown, it blended out nicely, and I only had to tap into the pan once in order to get it to apply, and then I would just spend some time blending it out. Whereas in the new palette, when I applied it, I had to apply it by dipping into my pan a couple of times. And that's not to say that's a bad thing. Maybe it's just the top of the shadow that needed to be dug into, because I gotta say, like, I've made a pretty decent mark in my old palette in that shadow. So I found it just took a couple of additional tries in order to get the opacity and the depth that I wanted on this eye here using the new palette. As you know, there are no super metallic shades in the Modern Renaissance palette, but Vermeer and Primavera are usually the ones you can use if you just want to add a little bit of sheen on your lid. And so I felt like Primavera, which is more of the gold tone color, would look really nice all over the lid, and that's what I did. The old palette went on really nice, same with the new palette. I didn't find any difference there, no fallout, beautiful sheen. I think you just need either a really small brush to pack things on, or just use your finger and tap it on and you should be good to go. And lastly, what you didn't see on camera was me using Vermeer, which is this more, I guess, diamond colored shade up here. That one I put in the inner corner of my eye as well as my brow bone. And I will say that the older version of Vermeer was a little more muted than the newer one. I feel like the new palette just popped a little bit more. And again, maybe that's just because of use, age, whatever, but I feel like I got more of a shinier finish with the new palette than I did with the old version. And I'm sorry I didn't record that on camera. I just literally got busy doing the rest of my face and completely forgot to turn on the camera to show you that application. However, what I can do is just dip one finger into the old palette, dip a second finger into the new palette. So here we go. Those are the two shades right there. This one here is the older palette. This one here is the newer palette. So again, they look very, very similar, if not identical. Here is my fabulous hand. So there's the old one, there's the new one. Whoops, there we go. And on camera, I mean, they look identical. As you can tell by that very long summary of both of these eyeshadow palettes, I feel like they performed almost identical. I don't believe the formula has changed, and quite frankly, I still love the Modern Renaissance palette. Now, is it my favorite palette from the ABH line? No, it isn't anymore. I actually have another palette, actually maybe two palettes, that I think are way better than this one. And I mean, while we're here, let me do a little ABH palette ranking for you. And here we go. This is rapid fire ABH palette ranking. And of course, I don't have all of the palettes in my collection. These rankings are just based on what I actually own and use. So the first palette that I adore and I would say is probably my favorite out of the entire line is the Soft Glam palette. I love how neutral it is, how easy it is to use. Again, the blendability of this formula, you can't deny it. And I feel like you can use these colors for just about every single occasion. Second is the Sultry palette for me. Now, admittedly, I did not purchase this when it first came out, but luckily ABH brought this one back for the holidays last year, and that's when I went ahead and picked mine up. This is what it looks like. It is a beautiful neutral palette, but I do love that it's got some more shimmer in here. Third is where I would put Modern Renaissance. Again, this is a gorgeous palette, great colors, good for everyday use, but for me it just ranks third. Fourth, I would put the Master palette by Mario. Mostly because of how neutral these tones are. Can you tell? ABH for me is all about the neutrals. In my opinion, Riviera comes fifth, and I think it comes fifth for me mostly because this was the first super bright tone palette that I ever saw from ABH. I loved how bright the pink and purple is. I love the metallic shades here, especially Seychelles. What a shade that is on the lids. My goodness. I would rank the Rizzi palette as sixth. I think this is a pretty palette. This one is newer to my collection. I picked it up when it was on sale. I really don't like paying full price for the ABH palettes, but yes, this did happen to be on sale on the Sephora website a little while ago, and I just decided to pick it up because I loved the metallics and the glitter in here. I thought it was just so pretty. And then lastly, I would put the Prism palette. I know a lot of people weren't a really big fan of this, but I purchased it because I thought it was just, again, a different color story, something that ABH wasn't coming out with. And it was all about Sphere. They added this beautiful neon green shade in here, and I thought that could be paired really well with some of the metallic shades here, especially Osiris. I think that is a beautiful, beautiful color. Yes, those are all of the ABH palettes that I own. No, I never purchased the Norvina palette, which was the little purple one that she came out with. I like the tones, but I already have other palettes with that same color story that I prefer quite a bit more. I did declutter the Alyssa Edwards palette. I think that's been the only palette I've ever gotten rid of from my Anastasia collection. I guess I can really summarize this whole video by saying my new palette and my old palette are pretty much the same thing. So if you were a little bit weary about upgrading the palette that you have, have right now because you've either hit pan or it's just old, expired, whatever, you want to get rid of it, you can feel very confident purchasing a new version because it's exactly the same thing. And now I'm going to turn the floor over to you. Let me know what you think about the Modern Renaissance palette. Do you still love it? Does it rank really highly in your favorite palettes in your makeup collection? Or is it a palette you decided to skip on entirely? And that's going to do it for this video. I am so grateful that you are all coming back and watching my video. I really hope to be uploading a little bit more frequently in the future. Please be patient with me. It's been a horrible year. I'm really gonna try to sit down and film and upload a little more frequently than I have over the last couple of years, but there's been so much that has happened in my personal life. If you follow me on Instagram, you'll know a lot of the story. If you don't, well, maybe one day I will sit down and film a proper video to tell you everything that's happened. And I think I can only do that when I'm really comfortable talking about it. Right now, things are still very raw for me. So that's where I'm gonna leave it. I'm just very grateful for you. If you feel like keeping up with me outside of YouTube, you are more than welcome to do that. I am quite active on Instagram. That's my primary social media account, so feel free to follow me over there. Otherwise, I just want to say again, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate you. I hope you stay beautiful, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye, everybody.